Guys, welcome back to my channel, and today I'm making a video over 10 pro tips that will help you maintain your box braids a lot longer. So right now I've had these box braids in since Thanksgiving, and it is now the 1st of January, so happy New Year's everybody, and they still look really, really good. And I've gotten a lot of questions from people about how I maintain them and what I do to make sure that my box braids stay looking fresh throughout the whole time that I wear them, and up until the point that I'm taking them down, they still look good and like I could keep them up a little bit longer. So I'm making a video about that for you guys today, and stay tuned so you can learn all the tips. And without further ado, let's get right into the video. The tips in any particular order, but again, I'm going to be looking at my phone, so if you see me glancing over, if you see me touching, I'm just touching my phone screen so I can make sure that it doesn't go dim and that I can read everything I'm writing down. But like I was saying, they're not in any particular order, but I've kind of grouped them together so you can like go segment by segment. It's not just like all over the place, even though it kind of will be all over the place. But yeah, so basically the first thing and the first tip that like anybody could have is make sure that you have a good braider. Don't just go to anybody. Like, it's good to support your friends and it's good to help people out, but don't just go into anybody to like save money because you don't want to spend it, because at the end of the day, the results that you get will be what you paid for. And with hair, that happens so often. Like, you can't expect somebody to do this amazing job and give you these bomb ass braids when you're not willing to pay the price. So the first thing that I would recommend is definitely going to a good hair braider. So the second thing is that if you don't want to go to a hair braider and you're somebody that does your hair at home like me, practice makes perfect. I still, up till this day, I've been doing hair since I was 13, and right now I'm almost 22, and I still watch videos all the time about how to braid better, how to have better grip, just all kinds of things that will help you continue to learn. So if you're not gonna find somebody that you want to go to and you want to learn yourself, practice makes perfect. Because the most important thing about braids is not necessarily the foundation, because of course you need to attach it well, but when you're braiding down, the most important part is like making sure that's very uniform, and that's what makes them look professional, and that's what makes them last longer. Because even if they start growing out like mine do, mine have a little bit at the root, because the braided down part is so well and it looks so professional, they don't look as old as they would if the braided down looked bad and the attachment was bad and everything was bad, even though my braids are bomb and nothing is bad about them. But in the case of you teaching yourself and wanting to learn by yourself, just make sure that you practice a lot on the part that's coming down and the foundation also. So the second thing that I want a tip to give, if you're going to somebody or if you're doing it yourself, make sure that your braider braids all the way down to the bottom of your braids. I get questions about this all the time, and my customers are always so surprised, but I braid all the way down. Like, even these braids are about a month and a half old, a month old, and look at the little bitty parts at the end. I braid all the way down. I always braid all the way down because it just makes it a lot neater. It makes them last a lot longer. So if you're going to a braider, make sure that's something that they do. And if you're doing them yourself, don't get lazy. Yes, it hurts your hands. Yes, it takes long. It's very tedious, but the result is so beautiful. So you want to do that. So make sure you're braiding all the way down. And then the third tip that I have is tie up your hair. So at night, like, for any style that you have, even when you have braids, even when you have your hair in a protective style, still tie up your hair, because that will not only protect your hair, but it's also protecting the edges. Because as you can see, my edges don't get braided up like that. I leave them out. And so if you're not tying up your hair, you're not protecting your hair from your pillowcases, especially if you don't sleep on silk or satin pillowcases. Which takes me into the fourth tip, is if you don't tie up your hair, make sure that you're sleeping on satin and silk pillowcases. This can be applied to anything, but this is still important when you have protective styles like braids, because you don't want your ends to get frizzy. You don't want your hair that's sticking out, like when your hair starts growing out and it starts getting frizzy in the braid, you don't want that to be damaged and break off. And also, you want to protect your edges. So if you're not planning on using a scarf, make sure that you're sleeping on satin and silk pillowcases. And then that goes into the fifth tip, which is, even if you are tying up your hair and you don't have satin and silk pillowcases, please use a king size bonnet, like the really, really humongous ones. If you don't know what I'm talking about, insert a picture like somewhere up here so that you can see what I'm talking about. But if you don't have silk and satin pillowcases and you tie up your hair, Another layer of protection that keeps the braids looking fresh and keeps them looking good at the bottom part is having a really, really big bonnet to still cover them up, because sleeping, if you're a wild sleeper, because like I, for one, am a really wild sleeper, so I move around a lot at night, and so my hair sometimes will be brushed all over my pillowcases. And the times that I don't sleep with my silken satin pillowcases, I'm using cotton pillowcases, that can still cause damage to my hair. Even though it's tied up, it's not covered up all the way. So using a king size bonnet, tying up your hair, or getting silk and satin pillowcases and tying up your hair, especially to keep your edges laid down. But if anything, make sure that your hair is tied up at all times and you have a satin or silk pillowcase at all times. The sixth tip that I have is moisturize your hair. Moisturizing your hair is super, super important, because first of all, dry hair looks dusty and crusty, and like when your hair is dry, it starts looking old automatically. So make sure that you moisturize your hair, and that also can promote hair growth, and that's usually why we're putting protective styles in our hair, to protect our hair and have it grow. So there's no point in you putting the style in when you're not going to take care of your hair under it. So make sure that you're moisturizing your hair. I use my oil. I put it in this thing, this little bottle, this Aunt Jackie's oil. Smells really, really good. But the oil that I put in here is, I use tea tree oil, Jamaican black castor oil, peppermint oil, and olive oil, and a few other oils. And all of those are for stimulating hair growth, stimulating my scalp, anti-itch, anti-dandruff, all that stuff. So putting those all together and using that as an oil every day or every other day keeps my scalp moisturized and keeps my scalp happy and keeps my scalp itch-free while I have braids, because my hair grows super fast and it itches super, super fast once I get protective styles put in. But I can't take my hair out that fast because nobody has time to be dealing with all of this hair. So I just use my oils and I set it and I forget it. Then the next tip after that, which is tip number 7, I think I got off with the numbering of these tips, but you know, just know that I will put them down below so you know which tip we're on. But the next tip that we have is laying your edges. So you don't have to have your edges laid to the gods. If you guys know my little sister, I've ever seen her, she has the most blessed and anointed baby hairs. Not all of us have that gift. Not all of us were blessed like that. God did not give us all the gift of baby hairs. And I, for one, was not given that gift, but I was given the gift of edges. And to maintain those edges and to keep those edges in my possession, I will moisturize my edges and I will lay my edges down. They're not going to be laid to the gods, but they will be laid down nicely. See, like right now, they're not like laid or anything, but I do have something on them to keep them looking not frizzy so that my hair doesn't look old. So that's another thing. Your box braids could look bomb, but your edges are looking just dry, non-existent, and that makes your hair look old and makes your hair look dusty really fast. So I advise you, even if you're not laying your edges down, just to make sure that you're moisturizing them so that they look good. So the next tip is, this is something I was telling my little sister earlier because I just did her braids, but when you're itching your scalp, don't get in there and go all over your head. That's a no-no. That's going to instantly make your scalp frizz up really fast and your roots are going to be really frizzy. And once your roots start looking frizzy, that just really kind of ends the style and really makes you want to take it out. So if you have a bobby pin nearby, or keep a bobby pin on your person at all times, so you can just stick it in there, do a little itch. You have nails, because some of us, you know, us bad bitches out there love to have our nails done all the time. So you just take your nail, get in there, or if you have fingernails or just using your fingers, just do it gently. Don't be in there just scratching your scalp. And scratching your scalp like that is also a sign that your scalp is dry. So that may be time for you to grab your oil and get to moisturizing. But don't scratch your scalp crazily. Just get in there and do a little scratch, 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 scratch. Don't do too much because that will frizz up your scalp. So then the next tip is using mousse to keep your hairs that are frizzy. So like, you don't really see any like frizzy flyaways in my head because I use mousse consistently to lay it down. Like, it just helps your hair look a lot cleaner. Like once your stylist, usually when I finish box braids or any type of style, I put mousse on it just to lay it down. But you can buy mousse from Walmart or buy mousse from the hair store and do that like once a week or twice a week, however you need it. Because sometimes if you have a silkier hair texture, your hair will frizz up faster. But just get some mousse and do that like once a week or twice a week and you'll be totally fine. It'll make it look just like new and just like the first time that you got it done. So invest in a good, nice mousse. The mousse that I have is from Walmart and it was like $3. And at the hair store, it's like $2. So just get some of that and you won't even have to worry about the flyaways that happen like on the actual braids. So the next tip, this is something that I feel like is something I personally like to do and I personally advise for my customers, because I provide braiding hair, so I don't have to worry about this anymore. But if there's a time where a customer wants to bring their own hair, I usually will tell them that unless they have this hair, I would like to provide my own hair, just simply because buying good quality braiding hair, like, if you do hair, you will understand what I'm talking about. But if you don't do hair, like, it changes things. Like, having good quality braiding hair makes the style just look better. Like, it just does. Like, I don't know how to explain it, how to put it another way to make it easier to understand. Even though it's more expensive, it's quality. And you'd rather have quality over quantity. Like, the 99 cent bags of hair versus the $4.99 bags of hair in Oklahoma, that's how much it is. I know in Texas, the prices are a lot different, because when I went down there, I was just like,
really, nigga?
You know, like, why is our hair so expensive here? But, you know, Oklahoma's great. I don't fuck you lying. Why yeah. You always- but anyway, so quality over quantity is so important when you're getting your hair done, because, like I said, the hair vendor that I buy my hair from, this is the hair, and it looks so good still, and it still looks like, it just looks so much more professional. And then if I would have went to go get the 99 cent bags of hair and got, like, 13 bags of that and did the braids, by this time the braids will still not look this clean. The hair, like, it's just a lose-lose. So I just advise you to buy good quality braiding hair if you're planning on keeping the style in for a long time, because it helps maintain the quality of itself, and it shows you over time what you paid for and the reason why you paid for it, quite honestly. Just like when you buy expensive things, you see the quality over time. Like, I do that with heels all the time. Like, I used to be like, Charlotte Russe is a place, get $10 heels. Then one day I'm walking at a party, my $10 heel breaks, and I look like a $10 fool. So buying expensive things is important sometimes, because quality is so much more important than quantity. All right, to the next tip. Oh, guys, those are all the tips. That I got through all the tips that fast and I didn't even notice, but there you have it, 10 pro tips that'll get you looking right with your box braids and make them last a lot longer. Thank you guys so much for tuning into my video, and I hope that you have a happy and wonderful new year. Bye guys, see you later.